Good morning, my friend. I hope you're doing well. This month is flying by, and whatever you are going through. And if you're having any kind of trouble, please shoot us a message on the prayer wall, wlee1md.com/prayer, and get this whole worldwide community praying for you. So wherever you are in the world listening, we appreciate you and are grateful for you. Lisa and Tata and I pray for you all the time, and we are so glad to be connected. If you're not getting the newsletter, drleewarren.substack.com, please, that is a vital part of this community, and there's a ton of great stuff out there for free. There's also an option to become a paid subscriber if you want to go deeper and have access to more of the archive of all this self-brain surgery and podcast episodes and all the things that we've been doing for all these years now. And I just, I'm going to take a kind of a day off today, bring you back an old quiet time episode that I did called Love Tomorrow More. And if you haven't been around too long, you may not have heard this before, to shake some things off, to cast aside some things that are holding us back. And one of the ways that we can really make deep change is when we get to the place where we can put a little gap in before we just re-engage in old habits and old behaviors and thought processes and addictions and patterns and all those things. If we can just get to where we put a little space in there and say, wait a minute, before I do this, I want to think about 5 minutes from now, 5 hours from now, 5 days from now. I want to think about tomorrow and the impact that my decisions right now will have on tomorrow. And do I love that more than I need to do whatever it is that I'm about to do right now, or however I'm going to feel, or whatever I'm going to engage in? So this is a good little reminder about loving tomorrow more. I think it'll be helpful with some good music from Matt Mary. I hope that wherever you are and whatever you're doing, you'll remember the one thing I have to teach you, if nothing else you can learn from all of this, is that you can't change your life until you change your mind. And you can start today.
Hey, are you ready to change your life? If the answer is yes, there's only one rule. You have to change your mind first. And my friend, there's a place where the neuroscience of how your mind works smashes together with faith and everything starts to make sense. That place is called self-brain surgery. You can learn it, and it will help you become healthier, feel better, and be happier. And the good news is you can start today.
Thanks, Lisa. Hey, so glad to have you listening today. I'm Dr. Lee Warren, and I live in Nebraska in the United States of America with my incredible wife, Lisa, my father-in-law, Tata, and the super pups, Harvey and Lewis. I'm a neurosurgeon and an author, and I'm here to help you harness neuroscience, the power of your brain, faith, the power of your spirit, and good old common sense to help you lead a healthier, better, happier life. Listen, friend, you can't change your life until you change your mind, and I'm here to help you learn the art of self-brain surgery to get it done. If you'd like the show, please subscribe so you never miss an episode, and tell your friends about it. If you tell two or three friends this podcast was helpful to you, imagine how much good we can all do around the world together. I'm Dr. Lee Warren, and I'm here to help you change your mind so you can change your life. Let's get after it.
I've been thinking about the prayer wall. A lot of heavy stuff on the prayer wall lately. We've gotten some private prayer requests this week, as I shared a little bit with you. Just some difficult things. I have a friend whose teenage child recently attempted suicide. We have just a lot of things that are going on. It just continues to illustrate the point of what Jesus was saying, that in this world you will have trouble, from John 16:33. But he also says, the thief comes to steal and kill and destroy, but I have come that you may have life and have it abundantly, John 10:10. So we have this quantum physics thing where two things can be and are true at the same time. Things can be hard, they can be beautiful. Things can seem impossible, they can be possible. It can be unsalvageable, and there can still be hope, all at the same time. So just I hope that this weekend you can recharge and refresh and recalibrate and reset and just get some time with you and your loved ones, and get out and enjoy the fresh air. Look at the stars. The stars and the moon have been amazing in the mornings lately. I'm so sorry. My voice is, I guess, just tired, but I'm having a lot of trouble with my voice cracking and clicking. So I hope you don't mind that this morning. It's early. I'm having some coffee with you, and just excited to go into a Friday where maybe things will be a little bit less hectic and a little bit less strenuous than they have been. And this weekend, we're going to just recharge and reset. So I wanted to share that with you, because I always come on and talk about how positive things are and how you ought to reframe your mindset and thinking and all that. And I don't ever want you to get the impression that I've got it all figured out, or that me and Lisa and Tata are the three people in the world that everything is always right and positive and happy. That's not true. We're just like anybody else. There's strenuous things that happen. And when you are overworked and overtasked, you need to remember what the Lord says. Rest, reset, refresh, recharge, renew. He'll make all things new, but you've got to let him, and you got to take some time to take a breath from time to time. So we're going to do that this weekend. Hey, I want to spend quiet time in Psalm 30 this morning. I'm just going to read Psalm 30. I've been praying and kind of meditating, thinking about this passage. There's a couple things in Psalm 30 that I want to make sure that I share with you. Of course, this is fertile ground. Tommy Walker's written songs out of Psalm 30. Many songwriters have used Psalm 30 to write. I'm trading my sorrows is a famous worship song, that the sorrow may last the night as joy comes from the morning. All those little verses come from Psalm 30. There's lots of good stuff. Trade my mourning into dancing, one of my favorite old Tommy Walker songs. All comes out of Psalm 30. This is fertile ground to find some of what I've been telling you about prehab. You find some words, you find some juice to put in your heart, that when challenges come along, when stressful things happen, these words will come back to you, and you can use them as bullets to shoot at the problem so you don't lose hope, okay? So Psalm 30, we're going to cover that ground. Just want to encourage you, going into the weekend, take some time to reset and recharge and refresh and reframe and let the Lord remake you, and next week will feel a little bit lighter, right? Don't just plug through it. Don't just keep working. Don't just keep pile driving everything. Take a minute. Take a breath. You're allowed to. You're allowed to schedule yourself some time off. You're allowed to schedule yourself some exercise. You're allowed. In fact, if you want to be a good steward of yourself, remember that one of the fruits of the Spirit is self-control. And that doesn't mean just not doing a bunch of things. It also means controlling yourself in a way that will produce recharging, exercise, rejuvenate. Spend some time listening to your favorite music this weekend. Just spend a little time not working or not doing the thing that's wearing you out so much. And God will reward that, and he'll help you remake yourself. We're going to do Psalm 30 as a quiet time this morning. Okay, my friend, here's Psalm 30. I'm going to play a little music behind it. It's something I recorded for Lisa years ago called Lisa's Eyes on my nylon string guitar. And I hope you enjoy that. I will extol you, O Lord, for you have drawn me up and have not let my foes rejoice over me. O Lord, my Lord, I cried to you for help, and you have healed me. O Lord, you have brought up my soul from Sheol. You restored me to life from among those who go down to the pit. Sing praises to the Lord, O you his saints, and give thanks to his holy name. For his anger is but for a moment, and his favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may tarry for the night, but joy comes with the morning. As for me, I said in my prosperity, I shall never be moved. By your favor, O Lord, you made my mountain stand strong. You hid your face, and I was dismayed. To you, O Lord, I cried, and to the Lord I plead for mercy. What profit is there in my death if I go down to the pit? Will the dust praise you? Will it tell of your faithfulness? Hear, O Lord, and be merciful to me. O Lord, be my helper. You have turned for me my mourning into dancing. You have loosed my sackcloth and have clothed me with gladness, that my glory may sing your praise and not be silent. O Lord, my God, I give my thanks to you forever. Amen. Friend, there's a lot in there. Find you some of those verses that can be useful to you as prehab to then use in your attack against the things that come along and not just be victimized by them. To make your days better, arm yourself with some prehab, and Psalm 30 is a great place to go.
Hey folks, this is Weldon Lister with American Scroll, and we're a proud sponsor of the Dr. Lee Warren podcast. You might ask, what is American Scroll? And I would say, hey, we're an apparel brand that's based on the scroll art that I've developed as a master engraver. You can find more about American Scroll and see our products at americanscroll.com or unclesi.com. And as a special for the Dr. Lee Warren podcast listeners, just use Dr. Lee at checkout and you'll get 20% off. Thanks and have a great day.
Pray through that, meditate through it, think about it. Let those words be useful to you. And I want to give you one thought today. I told you recently that I want you to love tomorrow more than you hate what you're feeling tonight. A lot of folks, a lot of people all around the world are struggling so much with whatever it is that they've been through or whatever they're going through or whatever the situation is in their life that they don't want to think about, that they come home at night every day and they turn their brain off. They turn the television on, they open up a bottle of wine, they get online and gamble, they get online and click on websites that they ought not to click on, they flirt with somebody from the office that they ought not to be texting with. They do something shop or do something to distract their brain from what they really ought to be working through and processing and trying to make better. So instead of working on it and getting the Lord to heal it and finding a plan and a strategy to deal with that thing, they just go numb themselves, anesthetize themselves so they don't have to deal with it. But then guess what happens? Tomorrow you wake up and you still have the problem. And you have the hangover, and you have the debt you have to pay, and you have the relationship that you messed up, and you have the wound that you gave your spouse with the angry words that you said, or whatever. And you have the regret that you didn't go to your kid's baseball game, and instead you came home and did X, Y, or Z. If you don't take care of it, then you have to deal with it later, plus the tomorrow tax of whatever it was that you did instead, right? So I just want to give you one thought. When he says, weeping may tarry for the night, but joy comes with the morning. And when he says, you've turned my mourning into dancing, that there's something that's implied there. If you don't let yourself do the weeping, you won't get the joy in the morning. In other words, if you anesthetize yourself, if you numb yourself from the problem, and you don't actually let God minister to and operate on and heal that problem or teach you how to deal with it or teach you how to negotiate it a different way, then you still have it to deal with the next day. So if you want the joy to come in the morning, you have to love tomorrow more than you hate today. Love tomorrow more, my friend. Weeping will tarry for the night, but only if you let yourself do it. Because he can't turn your morning into dancing if you're not willing to go through the morning. If you're not willing to go through the pain to find the light on the other side, if you just keep turning the lights off on your brain and numbing yourself to it, then you'll never actually process it and deal with it. That's something we had to learn with grief. You've got to learn to go through it. You can't just stuff it down. I did that to my shame. I did that with Iraq when I came home. I put everything in a trunk and closed it up and didn't deal with it. And then a few years later, it came roaring out in the form of PTSD that really was hard on me and my wife and my family because I didn't process it. I didn't let myself do the weeping through the night so that God could give me the joy in the morning. I wasn't willing to go through the sorrow, to go through the mourning, to go through the grieving, to go through the problem because I didn't want to feel it. And so therefore, God couldn't turn it into dancing until I was ready to submit it to him. The sum total of today, what I'm talking about with you today, my friend, in this short few minutes here, is just let yourself go through the morning. Let yourself go through the weeping so that he can give you the joy in the morning. Love tomorrow more than you hate what you're feeling today. That's the take-home message that I'm giving you from Psalm 30. Okay, go out to the prayer wall, drleewarrenmd.com/prayer. Get on the newsletter if you're not connected. drleewarren.substack.com is the newsletter. It's got all kinds of great stuff. I'm bringing you treasure trove of archived content there and new stuff every time. So just check out drleewarren.substack.com. Let's connect on a deeper level, okay? Use Psalm 30 as some prehab for you. And love tomorrow more than you hate what you're feeling today. And that will help you, my friend, to recharge and reset and refresh. And let him keep his own promise that the joy will come at the morning and that he'll turn your morning into dancing. But the good news about all of that, my friend, is that you can start today.
Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done. On earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Father, let your kingdom come. Father, let your will be done. On earth as in heaven, right here in my heart. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us as we forgive those who sin against us. Forgive them and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the heart.
Hey, thanks for listening. Please subscribe to the show so you automatically get every episode. And if you like the show, you'll love my weekly letter. Check out my writing at drleewarren.substack.com, drleewarren.substack.com. Get the free newsletter every week for my best prescriptions for becoming healthier, feeling better, and being happier through the power of faith and neuroscience smashing together via self-brain surgery. drleewarren.substack.com. And if you need prayer, go to the prayer wall at wleewarrenmd.com/prayer. The theme music for the show is Make Us One by Tommy Walker, graciously provided for free by the great folks over at tommywalkerministries.org. Check it out and consider supporting them. tommywalkerministries.org. Remember, you can't change your life until you change your mind. And the good news is you can start today. I'm Dr. Lee Warren. I'll talk to you soon. God bless you, friend. Have a great day.